Hello and welcome to Queersay with me, Andrew Kay. Delighted to welcome back to the studio this week, Charlie Carlton.
Hello.
Charlie, you're back at college.
Yeah, back at uni, punishing myself. Yeah, enjoying it a lot. It is great.
So you're back on your vocals course?
Yeah, I am.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Brilliant. Where can we come and hear you?
Well, at the moment, we're looking to book the LGBT Society, which is fantastic, by the way. We're looking to book here.
Oh, wonderful.
To do something kind of November time, if we've got space for that. Yeah.
Well, we'll have to promote it on the show place.
We will.
Let's take a look at our stories this week. And as you said before we came on air, oh dear, lots of bad news.
Yeah, it's a bit of a dark one this week.
Yeah. Well, the first story is that Brexit Party founder complains that it isn't right-wing enough because of gay and trans candidates. I mean...
Oh, poor baby.
Oh, no, bless her. She's going to have a horrible time because of it. Because she's going to have to deal with the realities of life.
And she's suffering so... Didn't you know, Andrew? She's suffering so much because she's straight. And being a straight person in this world is just so awful.
No.
So awful. We should really, like, give an outpouring to her. No, she's a twat. But... Like, am I allowed to say... Yeah.
No.
No.
Apologise for Charlie's language.
Sorry. But, yeah, she... Just people being people. People who like people.
I mean, some of the things she's saying are just so awful. She's fuming. It's being pushed down everyone's throats. Gay Sainsbury's, gay Red Arrows, gay coffee adverts. Mm. One of the things that's filled me with joy in the last year are the number of ads which actually represent the fact that society is very open these days.
Yeah, I know, but it's very placating a little bit, isn't it?
It's a little bit of tokenism.
Well, sorry, we have a story a little bit late. She actually says in reference to this, like, it is a bit of placating because it's just kind of like you have an advert and you've got to throw a gay couple in there now to be modern. You've got to throw someone who is ethnically in the minority
and all that tokenism,
sort of thing.
Yeah, it's still carrying on.
Yeah, the tokenism does carry on, but she is just literally completely and utterly forgetting the amount of straight ads. I would like to remind her that a straight ad, if we're going by her rules, a straight ad is a man and a woman in an advert together holding hands. That's a straight ad. Now, my love, I challenge you, look on your TV, have a day watching and count how many straight couples that you see and then tell me that we're shoving it down your throat.
Absolutely.
Okay?
Absolutely. She's on a hiding to nothing, this one. Yes, definitely.
But I don't understand as well, because it's career affecting the what she's saying. Like, that's not, honey, not modern politics at this point. Like, you're just going to damage yourself and your career. You're going to get the people behind you that are the people that are giving violence towards homosexuals.
Well, let's just let her damage her career.
But it incites hatred because people are agreeing with it. Like, and people are like, well, yeah, they are. There are a lot of gay people. Oh, I see the LGBT flag in Sainsbury's on Pride Month. Like, grow a pair and grow up.
Yeah. Let's move on. And this is a really awful story. Uganda has resurrected the Kill the Gays Bill and also aims to target those who promote homosexuality. I mean, we make so many steps forwards, and this is just so depressing.
Yeah, it is. It's.
I mean, it only failed to go through last time on a technicality, so
we've sort of known
for some time that this could still happen.
And that was the intention. What I'm worrying about as well, let alone for the poor LGBTQ plus people that are in Uganda at the moment, what I'm worried about is the countries that may follow suit.
Absolutely.
To Uganda, because there are a lot of countries that don't have... Yeah, exactly. And there's a lot of countries that don't have... I would say, I don't know, from a political standpoint from Britain, therefore we should probably cut trade with Uganda, full stop. Just from that sort of standpoint, from saying that we're not supporting a country that does this.
It also impacts on the refugees that are in our country already, who are already under threat of being deported.
And they are,
and going
still
back
being
to countries
deported.
Where actually the punishment is actually a death sentence.
Yeah.
And that's really
like
concerning.
Death. Like, it's ridiculous. And we had the story last time I was on about the person who got sent back to their country and he was under serious risk of death. The guy we were talking about, the media putting his picture
yes.
in it. Him being sent back because it didn't justify, but he was in a serious danger. What is going to happen?
I mean,
it's scary.
The whole thing's really shocking. Mm. I mean, it comes not long after the Sultan of Brunei saying that there will be a death sentence for homosexuals. And not only a death sentence, but stoned to death. We seem to be reversing. We seem to be going back to the Middle Ages.
Well, the reason why stoning is because they do it in a kind of biblical / Quran / Torah aspect. It is biblically Old Testament. I should say Old Testamentally, because that's all the same across the three. But it's Old Testamentally accurate to stone someone for the sexual immorality of homosexuality. So I understand, like, where they're coming from with the punishment, but, like, I just don't get, and people are, like, boycotting, like, well done celebrities for boycotting hotels that are run by the Sultan of Brunei,
yep.
but also the franchisees that own those hotels, because it's not in business, it's not that sort of situation, it's not just him at the top, like, yep. there are people that run the hotel separately, they should not be working.
I think
if I was a worker at that hotel, I'd get up and walk out. I'd tell them where to stick their job.
But the funny thing, well, a lot of people are not in the positions of doing that. But the funny thing is that a lot of hotels are populated by staff who do form part of the LGBT community.
Yeah.
So without them, they're screwed.
Yeah.
Let's move on. Man faces jail for homophobic abuse against a 9-year-old boy. Now, on one level, this is a horrible story. But on another level, it's fantastic because he's going to be jailed, we hope. For what he's done,
yeah,
and this,
but
is,
it was also like
terrible.
It's also not just homophobic, like it's not homophobic verbal abuse. Like he physically,
physically pushed
the
him,
kid
yeah.
as well. So it's assault.
When he made the boy cry, well. It's really horrible. And then said, "Why are you crying?" I'm paraphrasing because there's a lot of bad language in this story. I think it's. I mean, this is awful that someone thinks that it is appropriate to talk to a child that's not their own in this way. It's really inappropriate for an adult whose child it is to behave in this way. We know that. But this is fantastic. This is, and also, a lot of these stories we read, and this off the World Wide Web, they tend to come out of America. This is here. This is in Scotland. This is in our own country that this is happening.
Yeah.
How inappropriate can that be?
It is horrible and it's awful, and that poor kid, who probably, let's be honest, isn't gay. Like,
who knows? Who cares?
Could be, but like statistically,
irrelevant.
Perhaps not. And this disgusting stain of a man decides to say this, and that's what he is, folks. He's an absolute stain on our human society. If anyone, well, actually, no, I'm not going to say that, but I was going to say if anyone deserves to be stoned, hello.
Well,
but
let's not go there,
violence
Charlie.
Here. But it's awful. It's horrible. And he's a, I stand by what I said. He's
this
a stain.
Guy, Craig Stodden, has admitted that he did it. So it's not going to be much of a trial.
Yeah.
It'll just be a matter of sentencing.
But
sometimes, though, I think
that?
when
he's dumb enough to admit to that, like.
Well, no, I mean, it's good that he's admitted to it in one sense. The only sad thing about admitting and putting out saying guilty is that the trial will not expose a lot of the detail.
No.
He will just be
found guilty and it
will
just be like,
guilty,
and then
it will be
sentenced. It's not on the statistics as to what's happening.
Yeah. I think
what actually happened.
I mean, I'm glad he's admitted to it, but in a sense, we need to know more about these things, don't we?
Mm-hmm.
It's awful.
Yeah.
He ended up going to hospital. It's not like this is a light thing.
But it does, this sort of thing seriously affect someone into adulthood, especially at that sort of age, at 9. It's in formative years. It is something that can seriously psychologically affect this child for the rest of his life.
I will say at this point, Charlie,
scary.
I think a lot of young people are guilty of making the word gay a usable term of abuse.
See, I would disagree now. I think when I was growing up, 100%, because there was the whole 2000s moment, like, it was on Doctor Who, like, yeah. Rose Tyler called someone...
Oh, you're so gay.
Yeah, like, that was the
thing.
But
gay was used as a derogatory term, and, yeah. I think, in a way, it's been sanitised by a youth culture to use it as a derogatory term, not actually even meaning queer.
Yeah.
And I think that's sad. We've got to go to a break.
Yes, we do.
We could talk forever, you and I.
We could.
We're going to go to a break now, and when we come back, we've got more stories, and I hope something a little more cheerful. Mm. We'll see you after these ads. Hello, welcome back to Queersay with me, Andrew Kay, and my guest, Charlie Carlton.
Hello.
Now, Charlie, I want you to hold it in a little bit on this, because I know that the name of the man incites riot in you.
It really does.
This is thousands are calling for Piers Morgan to be fired by Good Morning Britain for dehumanising trans people. Well, there's all sorts of things that I'd want him sacked from Good Morning Britain for, and this is now at the top of my list as well. Mm. I absolutely agree with you. I mean, what does the man think? I mean,
I know exactly what he's thinking. He's playing up to it simply because of the fact that there's the saying, any press is good press. And ITV keep him around because he's a controversial figure, which then bring more views to their channels because everyone's like, oh, my goodness, Piers Morgan's on there. What's he going to say next? So it's bringing more viewers. So strategically, it's very clever of ITV to do. That's why they will never fire him.
But isn't there a fine line between what they're doing and incitement to hatred?
Yeah, but they seem to want to toe that line. I'm calling you out, ITV, on this, because... you are towing that line and you're allowing this to happen. By doing nothing about this situation, you are inciting hatred. It's not Piers Morgan, because Piers Morgan is just a mouthpiece. He is doing what he is doing so that he can create that tension, that press, so that in the Good Morning set, it's not Good Morning. Yeah, it is Good Morning Britain. Good Morning Britain set, then he can... bring around that hatred, have Susanna Reid have those arguments with him so that we're all siding with Susanna, so we're all like, yeah, Susanna, yeah, let's go. But it's just a very clever strategy by ITV to get this person
here. He's not
sitting
at home thinking, ooh, Jeremy Kyle, look what happened to him. Maybe I need to rein it in.
No, because he's got it worked out. And that's the thing. He's got it absolutely worked out. By being a controversial figure, he's managed to secure... his position. I mean, look who's president of the United States at the moment. He is a controversial figure.
I thought we were
going
to get through a program without mentioning him.
Well, sorry, but but he is a controversial figure. Look at the Britain First head, controversial figure. They're able to get the press and they're able to get the celebrity because of the fact that people love to hate him so much that it brings more attention to it. So I'm saying to the people, boycott ITV, boycott this Good Morning Britain so that this doesn't work. Because from a TV point of view and from a business point of view, he is fantastic because he's bringing views.
I mean, let's face it, a huge section of the population absolutely adore car crash television.
Yeah.
You only need to turn on Channel 4 and ITV to see Love Island and all of these things.
Yeah, but just watch Love Island. Just watch Big Brother.
Have to say, I don't watch any of them. I feel like someone's trying to drag my soul down through my adenoids when I turn on programmes like that. Yeah. I find them deeply, deeply depressing.
See,
and for the same reason,
them,
I can't watch these sort of programmes.
Yeah, and that's
but
the
I do
thing,
worry.
For it to
I
go
do worry
to
that they're,
news.
They're allowing him to continue to do this. Mm. And I do think someone needs to intervene. And I think they're right to call for his sacking, definitely. I think they're also right to call for a boycott of advertisers. And any advertiser who is worth their weight
100%.
Should be saying, I'll continue advertising on ITV, but I don't want my ads to be anywhere near Piers Morgan.
No.
And I think, that's the big call out here.
He should be seriously blacklisted. Like, I understand why they're doing it, as we've discussed. It's a very clever business tactic to do that. But it's just not appropriate in this day and age, because at the moment we're at such a hot point with the LGBT community.
Yep.
And things are were finally getting just a bit better, and then they're just going to be slammed down by men who are weak, feeble white men just being absolute idiots about things. I mean, hello, well, Prime Minister.
It's men and women.
These views are my views, not the views of Latest TV, I'd like to say.
That's why you're here.
I hate him. I really don't like this man.
I don't like him either. Let's move on. Because this one, I loved this story. And this comes from America, but the Archie comic book company have actually had characters coming out as queer for National Coming Out Day, which was last week. How wonderful.
Love that little nod.
I think it's wonderful. I can remember when I was growing up, I wasn't even vaguely interested in Superman and Wonder Woman and all of those, but I did quite like a copy of Archie from time to time. So the fact that it's one that I actually read as a kid back in the 1960s, it's lovely now that they have gay characters. And having looked at some of the strips, they're really well put together.
They're really sweet and just really, like...
Well, I think they're normalising.
The responses are really good, because they have, for example, we have a character called Claire. So Betty says, "Hey, Claire, who have you been texting so much? Your boyfriend?" Claire goes, "Well, I know, Betty, I've been texting my girlfriend." And Betty goes, "Oh, well, all I have to say about this is... When do I get to meet her?" Yeah. In due time, Betty. Like, it's just such a sweet, heartwarming thing. It is perfectly done. They've had... And it's not a situation where they've been, like, ignoring the LGBT community and then suddenly putting this in just to jump on the bandwagon.
Absolutely.
I mean, they've had Kevin Keller in the comics, and they have Riverdale now, which is very kind of pro-LGBT, although I would really like to see more LGBT content on there, Riverdale, hello. But it is brilliant. It's coming from a good place. It's coming from positive aspects.
The whole storyline is positive.
Yeah.
I think a few years ago, if Betty had come out and her friend would say, it would have been, oh dear. You know, it wouldn't have been, when am I going to meet her? But it's a sort of... It's good that she comes out, and it's good that the response to her coming out is positive.
Yeah, and it's just like a... It's the exact kind of response that I like to see in TV and media, where it's just literally a situation where it's like, oh, I happen to be gay, I happen to be trans. It isn't anything that guides the story massively. It's not like, oh, my God, he's gay, how's Betty going to deal with this?
And I'm going to get beaten up, my family are rejecting me.
It's not about that. It's just about a character just happening to be gay. Like, I'm a big proponent of, in TV shows, think of, this is a poor example, but think of, like, the movie Twilight. Easily, Bella could be a male character. Easily, Edward could be a female character. And the thought of that just being placed in there, it has no consequence on the story, it has no anything. It's the exact same sort of love story, and it's not about them being gay. This is how I think that people should be writing gay characters. So it's not just all about us coming out and all about us...
Bad news.
Like, having awful situations, awful experiences, which, of course, does happen in the gay community, not disputing that at all, but I just want to see more media that is just kind of like...
Positive.
Oh, he's gay.
Like, let's move on, Charlie.
Yeah.
Because we've only got time for one more story.
I'm too passionate about
it. And I liked this story. I think it's very funny. The Dancing on Ice company, TV show, have revealed that they're going to have their first same-sex dance partners, and they're doing it before Strictly does it. Well, of course they're doing it before Strictly does it, because Strictly hasn't done it and it's already on. Now,
I'm kind of confused, because Strictly Australia... or a dancing show in Australia had Shane Jennick, otherwise known as Courtney Act, on it as a same-sex couple. And I saw this story last year.
In Australia, not in the UK.
See, it doesn't say in the UK.
Yeah. It's Dancing on Ice in the UK is going to have same-sex couple. They haven't actually said who it... Oh, yes, they have.
Yeah, they have.
Yes, it's H from Steps, also known as Preparation H.
He's the blonde one.
He's the gay one.
Is there any one gay one?
I've no idea.
I think
although
it's a blonde one.
I actually have seen Steps live.
Oh,
and I saw H in a pantomime a few years ago. I have to say, He was very good.
So you should know the colour of his hair.
He was very good.
Though.
Well, he's blonde, but aren't they?
Yeah, he's
aren't
blonde.
All pop stars blonde?
No, there's I thought blonde they had to be. One and there's a brunette haired one.
I don't know them
it's
that well.
The blonde
well.
One. Okay.
I don't know
cool.
them that well. And he's being paired with Matt Evers. Well, I mean, are they going to have an advantage in the lifts?
No, I don't think they are. Well, it really depends on your body type, like yeah. on how that goes. It does not matter if you're male or female. If you look at some of the stuff, and I encourage you to, if you look at some of the stuff that Courtney Act did down in Australia, the lifts were perfect, but that's because she's quite a slim
yeah.
person in drag and out of drag.
I don't think getting into drag puts weight
lift.
On, does it?
I don't know, you've got your pads.
I suppose so. I think it's an interesting story, this, because it's actually, it talks about H and how he didn't come out when Steps was first on the scene.
Yeah.
Because there was an awful lot of pressure for him not to. But also because he hadn't come to terms with himself and he also hadn't told his family. But he's out there now as a big sort of
proponent of the gay community, which is really good.
Excellent. And I think it's great that they've actually announced this in advance and they're making something of it. And I think it's really important that we do make something of these stories. We're running out of time.
Mm.
It's really great having you back in. And please come back in a few weeks' time.
I will.
And I'll find you some stories. Or perhaps you'd like to bring some stories in as well.
Yes, I will be. I think maybe a small, like, media representation segment could be coming your way.
Okay.
Just instantly comes in and changes the show. It's not an official thing that's happening, guys.
No,
Don't worry. We need
to talk about that. Honestly, what's he like?
Just ideas.
And you can come in and talk about your charity night.
Yes.
That will be good.
Yeah, once we get all kind of things finalised.
Well, thank you for coming again. Thank you for watching Queersay. We'll be back in a week's time with 6 more stories of how the LGBT+ community is represented in world media. Until then, good night.